Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Hold My Nugget Studios once again for your third game of Divisional Weekend, live from a stadium where the only piece of the arrow people care about is the head. As the Cleveland Browns make an appearance in the divisional round of the playoffs for the first time since 1994, and Kevin Stefanski is finally on the sideline for a playoff game. And it's been a tumultuous 3 weeks for the Cleveland Browns, but they've been able to persevere, and here they are in Kansas City to take on the reigning, defending, undisputed Super Bowl champions of the NFL. But it'll be quite the tall task to dethrone the kings of football, because coming off of a bye, nobody does it better. Since 2018, following a bye week, the Kansas City Chiefs score more than a one percenter with a $1 million budget on escorts, and they're led by their signal caller, Patrick Kermit the Frog Mahomes. In the last 24 starts, only lost one game to those fucking Gruden grinders. But nevertheless, Mahomes has played in 5 playoff games. He's 4-1, the reigning MVP in the Super Bowl, and he's never thrown an interception in the playoffs, looking to run it back as the top-seeded Chiefs host the Cleveland Browns in your 2020 NFL playoff divisional round game highlight commentary. And here come the Chiefs. Patrick Kermit the Frog Mahomes wastes little time entering Browns territory as he'd find that swooping midget Tariq Hill inside the 25. Hot.
Now you see now, you done fucked up, you know that, don't you?
Mahomes so damn disrespectful. He knew he had a free play and he still threw the football at the Browns.
Oh, fucking do it again.
Offsides on the defense. That's gonna be a 5-yard penalty. It was 2nd and 4. Automatic first down.
Well, shit. What are y'all doing?
This is a disrespectful ass stat. Why would you even say they scored 38 out of 39 red zone drives and you gonna signify one was a kneel down? Just say 38 straight. That's like saying a gunman only connected on 15 of 16 rounds, only to find out he left one bullet in the chamber. This disrespectful. But does Patrick Kermit the Frog Mahomes give a shit? Absolutely not, because he'd run into the end zone himself. Touchdown, Chiefs. They're on top, and it's too easy for Patrick Mahomes. Why? Because
it's free real estate.
Wait a minute. You could have saw this video early and ad-free if you became a level 3 to 6 member on my Patreon, www.patreon.com/chiseledadonis, to get access to those perks.
And how nice of Harrison Butker to donate the football to the fans. He didn't even kick it into the net. I think Roger Goodell might fine him for possibly spreading more fans to COVID. You kick the football into the stands, you know about 50 people about to fight for that shit.
Bitch, you guessed it.
You was right.
You owe me money. Have to give me back my money.
Unfortunately for Roger Goodell, it seems as if they can't find Patrick Mahomes because he threw the football out of orbit and it landed somewhere on the moon. So it seems like he'll be hearing from NASA very shortly.
I'm in control here. You're going to give me what I want. You know what it is. Give me what I want.
You know what I want. You're going to give me what I want, or I'm going to continue to hurt people you love. Give me what I want. Give it to me. Give me what I want.
Roger Goodell really wants that money. Nevertheless, Patrick Mahomes has scored on the ground in 3 consecutive postseason games. But here comes his adversary, the Cleveland pastry chef, Baker Mayfield, fresh off of a wild card victory over the Pittsburgh Steelers. And on his first pass of the day, he'd take a trip to Wakanda because he'd get the football to David Njoku-Jogu. And he'd take it all the way into Chiefs territory. And the old lunchroom stigma still holds true in the professionals, because it seems nobody in football respects basketball players, as Austin Hooper was left by himself to move the chains.
Hey, watch your mouth, woman! Watch your mouth, woman!
2nd and 12, here comes Baker.
Come here.
The Browns would have to settle for a Cody Pocket field goal. And could you believe he's perfect in the postseason? I wonder what his lone miss is.
Cody Parkey game-winning field goal, 43 yards out. He kicks it through the uprights. It's good. The Bears are on to Los Angeles. But wait a minute. It was all a genjutsu.
They didn't know we called Fat Tony. Put that motherfucker on ice. Timeout, pussy. Joke's on him. We got a reliable kicker. Cody Parkey, 43 yards out. To send the Bears to Los Angeles, the kick is gonna be... It was tipped at the line. It hit the upright. It doinked twice. It's no good.
I cannot believe it.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Oh my god.
Yes.
No.
This has been happening all season. You go back to week 10, Lions versus Bears. Off the right upright. Your next field goal was off the left upright. Your next one was off the right. And the final one was off the right again. Then against the Vikings last week. You you would kick it off the right upright. Then tonight, with the game on the line, you would... you would connect with the left upright. Somebody get Vince McMahon on the phone, because there's a special cosplayer. It's Doink the Clown and his friend Dink, Cody Parkey. The Bears thought they had a reliable kicker, but the lie detector determined that was a lie. Cody Parkey! Were you participating in the Bird Box Challenge? I would rather let my underage daughter go to the studio with R. Kelly than have you as my kicker. Put your motherfucking head back down, you goddamn bum!
And here he is once again, 46-yard field goal. The kick is through the uprights and good.
Thank you, Jesus!
Ensuing Chiefs drive, Miko's girlfriend says he doesn't have to take Cialis because he's always a hard man, carries it deep in Browns territory. But wait a minute, when did Myles Garrett have jets like that? He hawked that motherfucker. Why nobody told me Myles Garrett was out here boosting his attributes before the game? Homie out here going stride for stride with Miko Hardman. What an amazing effort. Two plays later, this time Myles Garrett was nowhere to be found as Mecole Hardman would move the chains once again inside the 25. And how nice of the Kansas City Chiefs to have a snack in the middle of the game as they'd get the football to Brian Pringles to move the chains again. Into the second quarter we go, and looks like Travis Kelce out here looking like John Cena with the flying shoulder block.
Get your bitch ass out the way, nigga.
And into the end zone for the Kansas City Chiefs touchdown. And it's too easy for Patrick Mahomes. Why? Because... but why he did that to Denzel Ward?
Snake, are you okay? Snake? Snake?
My leg!
I broke my ankle.
I'll fucking do it again.
Okay, give me your shoe.
A shoe?
I got a stone in my shoe.
There's sand in my shoe!
Ensuing drive, Cleveland pastry chef Baker Mayfield letting it float to the people's champ inside Chiefs territory.
I did it for the Rock. I did it for the people.
Two plays later, he dump it off to Nick Chubb on 2nd and 20.
I dropped it.
Yo, running backs this weekend don't got no hands, bruh. How you can't catch a football from that close proximity? Somebody lower this man's Madden rating. What's wrong with him?
What happened to his head?
3rd and 20 for Baker Mayfield.
Fine, I'll do it myself.
The lie detector determined
that was a bad decision.
Baker got stopped like a black man in a white neighborhood. The Chiefs defense told him to get high on his own supply. Following drive, Patrick Kermit the Frog Mahomes takes the snap, rolling towards his right. He's got Travis Kelce again abusing that Brown secondary. Ain't it crazy how Damian Williams sat out this season and the Chiefs just replaced him like nothing happened? He sat out to save his family from COVID and the Chiefs just came out here and...
they took our job!
They took our game!
3rd and 8, Mahomes takes the snap, and much like eating a capsule of cyanide, he says, fuck it, I'll do it myself, as he pick up the first down and move the chains.
It is, you told me it was my turn.
This man responded to a high five with a fist. Wait a minute, something is wrong. Mahomes is limping. You're not allowed to get hurt.
That's wrong, that's wrong, that's wrong, that's wrong.
Don't overexert yourself. Just trust in your teammates. After Adrian Claiborne would commit homicide, the Chiefs would call out Harrison Butker for a 50-yard field goal. He bangs it through the uprights, and it's good. Back to Wakanda goes Cleveland pastry chef Baker Mayfield on 2nd and 20 on the ensuing drive, as he's got David Njoku Jobu. Disregards Tyrann Mathieu inside the 45. And then the Browns would foreshadow what to come, because Cleveland pastry chef Baker Mayfield finds Rashad Higgins inside the 25, and he's looking towards the end zone and tells the pylon, I'm coming. Very next play, here comes Higgins, because the Browns are driving down the field and they're looking like Derek Vehicle. Beep, 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 beep. Butterfingers fumbles out of the end zone. It's ruled a touchback. This is like the loser of the presidential race. All that work for nothing. They don't call him Dirty Daniel Sorensen for nothing. Looks like Toros used Zen headbutt. And it's super effective.
Oh, he almost had it. You gotta be quicker than that.
One's gotta wonder how Derek Carr feels watching this. You're just sitting at home, the playoffs is going on, somehow you're trending because idiots are participating and you fumble into the end zone challenge. Does that make him a Gruden grinder? I think so, but this isn't the kind of Gruden grinding I like.
Ain't this some shit?
No! No!
failure.
What's crazy is this was a clear helmet-to-helmet and should have been flagged for a 15-yard penalty. Good thing Daniel Sorensen's been in the NFL and his name's not James Golski while playing college football at Clemson, because he would have been ejected for targeting.
Here I go.
Brutality.
Do it again.
Fatality.
I'll fucking do it again.
Okay. I'll make him bleed.
Rumor has it Case Keenum's gonna retire from the NFL and start an OnlyFans. For his wife, she'll be showing feet. For Case Keenum, he'll be showing balls. And with under a minute left to play before halftime, the Chiefs look to advance down the field as they're already in Browns territory. The Browns really just gonna let Travis Kelce do whatever the hell he wants? That's like the house in every neighborhood that has a dog that's absolutely wild. Ain't nobody supervising that motherfucker. And with 15 seconds before the break and one timeout remaining, Mahomes would find Kansas City midget Tariq Hill. He's gonna carry it inside the 15 and put them in magnificent field goal position for Harrison Butker. On a 28-yard attempt, he kicks it through the uprights. It's good, 19-3 at the break.
Hey, you know, a minute, we did it! We did it! We have surpassed the 10K follower mark threshold on the Hot Mic app. So what does that mean? It is confirmed the giveaway has been completed. We're announcing the winner on Super Bowl Sunday, and now I won't have to scheme the people. I can't scam you. Initially, if we stayed at 9,999 people, I would have probably held on to the console myself, but then somebody had to go and make it the 10,000. So now that we're past 10,000, I gotta give these son bitches away. I'm never gonna get an opportunity to play you, at least these two in particular. I will have to probably buy another one for myself. But damn it, giving them away Super Bowl Sunday. If you haven't already entered, you missed out, god damn it. You missed out.
Into the second half we go, 3rd and 10 for Cleveland pastry chef Baker Mayfield, and he's cooking up some apple. Turnovers! Pass intercepted by that honey badger, Tyrann Mathieu, and he returns it all the way inside the 20.
Where the fuck did he come from?
Look at the lineman behind him.
My hand!
Look at the bottom of the screen. Tyrann Mathieu just running all over the field.
Yoink.
Jarvis Landry had to be thinking to himself,
hey, it's our ball!
I'm here to tell you right now, we don't care.
You know, for a pastry chef, Baker Mayfield's not actually throwing that many apple turnovers. Very next play following the interception, Mecole Hardman's getting outside once again, but he only picked up 5. But wait a minute!
My chest!
I'm gonna kill Mason. But he's not the reason why. I said what I said. They'd send out Harrison Butker for a 33-yard field goal. The kick is... Did he just doink it off the upright? This entire postseason, we've seen a gang of doinks, but this time an arrowhead across from Doink the Clown himself. Butker out here looking like Cody Bucky. Can't forget his only doink in the postseason. They called Chicago the Windy City, but you were the tornado that ravaged their playoff hopes. Out here with a double doink the WWF couldn't even produce. Cody Bucky. We've got a better chance achieving world peace rather than seeing you make a big time kick. Stephen Hawking could probably beat Usain Bolt in a 100-meter dash before you make a meaningful kick. Put your motherfucking head back down, you goddamn bum! Ensuing drive, here comes the Brownies with no contraband. Hand off to Nick Chubb, and look at them carrying Chiefs. I'm sure descendants of pilgrims are looking in history books like we used to do that. Fucking assholes. And clearly, Nick Chubb must have his GPS open, because this man's finding every route through that Chiefs defense and carries it into Kansas City territory. Two plays later, Cleveland pastry chef Baker Mayfield's got the winner of the Derek Vehicle Challenge, Rashad Higgins, at the 15. And now in the period colored zone, Cleveland pastry chef Baker Mayfield's got Jarvis. Bless him then, participating in the 10 toes down challenge in the end zone. Cleveland cuts their deficit to 9. Look at those educated feet. It doesn't have to sell themselves on OnlyFans to get a buck. Ensuing drive, 3rd and 1. Mahomes gonna take it himself. Looks like Eno might have hit him with the mind transfer jutsu, because Patrick Mahomes' brain is not there. It's a soulless vessel. He's going to have to leave the game. 1 second he was in Kansas City. Right now he thinks he's back in Texas Tech.
Everybody get a doctor out of here. Don't just stand there. Get a doctor out of here right now. EMTs, get him out of here.
All he heard in his left ear was...
That you could do so you want him to do you so much you could do anything.
Return of the Mac Wilson done knocked out Patrick Mahomes. When he come back to his consciousness, I know he's gonna be screaming. All jokes aside, this is something nobody wants to see. I don't care if you're a Cleveland fan, you hate the Kansas City Chiefs, you hate the Muppets, or you just enjoy seeing people's soul ejected from their body. Patrick Mahomes is going to be the face of the NFL, and man's just got knocked out in a playoff game. And it was a bang-bang play. Mac Wilson didn't intend to do a gator roll with this man's head. His arm just so happened to get caught underneath his helmet. You could see it in Patrick Mahomes' eyes. He not even there no more. His mind completely clocked out of work. And that hit would put him in the concussion protocol, and he's out of this game. As he heads to the locker room, into the lineup comes Chad Henne, a 13-year vet, but this is his postseason debut. And Andy Reid continues to showcase his balls are larger than the unchiseled Adonis, because he'd go for it on 4th and inches from his side of the field, and they'd convert. Look at bum-ass Cody Parkey in the background. Get your ass up out of here. The amount of injuries that people are battling through this year has been astounding. Don't ever question their toughness. Kansas City offense literally just plug and play. It don't matter who go down, they still gonna be productive. Now inside the 25. That set up Harrison Butker for a 33-yard field goal once again. This time, he kicks it through the uprights, and it's good. 22-10. And on the play before the field goal, Tariq Hill actually got himself open, but Chad Henne never saw him. Where the fuck is Patrick Mahomes? He's hurt. I don't give a fuck.
Have some compassion.
What? Almighty push.
Fuck out of here, you stupid ass motherfucker. I beat you like I did my girl and my kids.
Allegedly, that's ignorant.
He lucky we at work right now. I'll beat that motherfucker ass.
I volunteer as tribute.
Ensuing drive, here come the Brownies with no contraband. Once again, Baker Mayfield finds Rashad Higgins inside Chiefs territory. And on the first play of the fourth quarter, they'd move the chains on 3rd and 3. They're now inside the 30. You know Kareem Hunt didn't have a touch in the entire first half. He's gonna be kicking somebody on the staff. 4 plays later, 4th and 2. Look at Kareem Hunt at the top of the screen. Wide open. Nobody was gonna touch that man. But luckily, they're able to extend their drive. And Kareem Hunt would get vengeance against his former team as he'd activate his dreadlock powers, hunt, and seek the end zone for the Browns' touchdown.
I'm gonna take a nap.
Hello, friend.
I don't know you.
We the Browns, and we coming back. We the Browns, and we coming back.
You ain't gonna do shit.
Ensuing drive, Tariq Hill would whisper in a man's ear, hold my nuggets, suck my dick, and move the chains. And then a few plays later, Chad Henne would find Travis Kelce over the middle, abusing.
Taki, 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 rumba.
Well, you kids, shut up.
Fuck them kids. Fuck them kids.
Hey, I hope you're enjoying the video thus far, but make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. But more importantly, follow me on all social media networks, whether that's YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Pornhub, TikTok, doesn't matter. Follow me on all platforms, because they continue to block me. Back to your regular schedule program.
So just do it!
And it looks like Chad Henne learned something from Patrick Mahomes, because fuck it, Tariq Hill down there somewhere.
Give me that.
Pass intercepted in the end zone by the Cleveland Browns. But would the Browns do anything with the football on 3rd and 11? Absolutely not, because they'd be participating in the Frank Costanza Challenge.
I stopped short.
Well, that didn't work.
Exactly 1 minute later, opportunity to get the football back, 3rd and 4. Darrell Williams moves the chains and extends the drive. I took out a loan to pay for this chain, man. Y'all can't lose now. Y'all just got hope. 2 plays later, after using their final timeout, Chad Henne would be taken down for the sack by Myles Garrett.
What the fuck?
Down by 5, 1 stop on 3rd and 14 could get the Browns the football back. But for Chad, anything is possible, because he's going to carry it for the first down and put this game away as he take the Kansas City Chiefs into the Gangsta. He got stopped before crossing over like people who are kept in comas. It's gonna be 4th down and the length of a dildo. Game on the line, trip to the AFC Championship, 4th and inches, backup quarterback. Who gives a shit, says Andy Reid. As Chad Henne would find Tariq Hill, they'd get the first down. This man's balls are so big, his scrotum must be by his ankles. Pause.
Get your big ass up out of here, bitch.
The Browns unable to stop the clock. There's the final kneel down, and for the 3rd consecutive year, the Kansas City Chiefs will host the AFC Championship.
Allegedly, that's ignorant.
And with this victory, Andy Reid would become the first coach in NFL history to host 3 consecutive championship games with 2 different franchises. One time with the Chiefs, the other with the Eagles.
Eagles beanie. Taste these motherfucking balls, bitch. You like that? You like that, don't you?
taste all these motherfucking balls, my.
Man, what the fuck is you
what
talking
the
about?
What was that?
I'm sorry, man.
It's okay, baby, cousin son. You will find.
Damn, Andy Reid left Kareem Hunt hanging like he did after he found out about the kicking incident. As the Chiefs are on to the AFC Championship, but for the Browns, they'd be taking out their Metro cards and getting aboard the L train. But their ride would be short-lived because they've arrived at Elimination Station for their failures of getting the job done in advancing to the AFC Championship and advancing to the AFC Championship for the first time since 1987. Their failures of taking down the Kansas City Chiefs and preventing them from going to their third consecutive AFC Championship. Consider their names written down the death note, because their dreams of debuting in the Super Bowl, their dreams of finally restoring prestige to their organization, has been absolutely deleted.
There's only one thing left to do. Gotta write their names in the death note.
Delete!
Delete, delete, delete.
Delete!
Delete, delete,
delete. Delete! Delete,
delete, delete.
Delete,
delete, delete.
Deletion.
You will rest in peace.
Fight, Eagles, fight. Score a touchdown. 1-2, 1-2-3. See that ass right there, my nigga?
Oh my god. Oh my god. He on X Games mode.
We're going to the Super Bowl! Dumbass fucking retarded motherfuckers. Fuck that shit.
Tell me I did not just see that.
Ah, what they doing in their house? That's nasty!
Some bitch. He's fat. I'm gonna.
About this.
I don't care if he don't. I'll make him bleed.
You missed out. You missed out. You missed out. I'm giving him away on Super Bowl Sunday, but you missed out. You missed out.